to see is a fib, but it's short. The names are made up, but the problems are real.
It was Monday, 9:43 a.m., and things at Anaheim Stadium were making the sports fans extremely happy. Baseball season was over for the Angels, and the Rams were playing out of town. I was working the day watch out of Mathnet. The boss is Thad Green. My partner is George Frankly. My name is Monday. I'm a mathematician.
Happened to me over the weekend, George.
I'm happy for you, Kate. I'm happy for you.
George, what's the matter?
Kate, I can't dance. Don't ask me.
What?
Martha and I are going to a dance Wednesday.
Should be fun.
But I don't dance well, and I just had a lesson.
A dance lesson?
Yeah, at Twinkle Toes Travolta's dance salon.
Seen their ads on TV. They say they can teach you to dance in a half an hour.
That's the one. It didn't work.
Oh.
I'll never learn to dance, Kate. And Martha will be embarrassed again.
Don't be silly, George. Martha won't be embarrassed. I know. Maybe. I can teach you to dance.
No, please, Kate. I might hurt you.
Don't be silly. Bill.
I didn't mean to interrupt.
Look, Kate was just teaching me something new.
Mm-hmm.
A dance step, Bill. George thinks he can't dance.
I wouldn't know anything about that. Listen, Mathnetters, you've had a big increase in car thefts. Look at this.
Oh, Debbie does graphs.
Why are you showing this to us, Bill?
We're swamped, and the chief suggested you two might help us.
Sure thing. We like to help out. Help-wise, I mean.
This is a bar graph that indicates car thefts in the greater Los Angeles area for the past 5 years, month by month.
Uh-huh. Doesn't look very unusual.
Doesn't vary very much. What's that one, Bill?
Car thefts for this year? Just look at this. This is a blow-up of the chart for January through August. Just look at the last 2 months.
What a jump.
In those 2 months, thefts are 295%. Of what they were for the same period last year.
295%? That's nearly three times as many.
Yes, and to add to the mystery, most of the stolen cars aren't appearing on the street or anywhere.
That is unusual. We normally find them. They may not have an engine or the tape deck or the radio, but we find them.
Yes. Well, if they were stolen and sold to some unsuspecting buyer, they'd still turn up eventually.
Right. We figure they might be going to chop shops.
You mean where they chop the cars up and sell the parts?
That's right, George.
You checked that out?
Just 2 weeks ago, we closed down a giant chop shop ring that was operating throughout California, so that's not a major factor.
We'll get right on it, Bill.
Appreciate the help. Oh, good luck to you, Fred. And you too, Ginger.
We'll get back the invitation to the dance later. Let's check with Debbie. What do you think of those charts, mathematician? Something funny is going on, Debbie. I think what we need is to look at the information. It's all stored in the computer and the database.
Database. Good. I was hoping we'd be able to use a computer software program that allows us to store all kinds of information and organize and reorganize it so it can be retrieved selectively. Weren't you, Kate?
More than anything in the world. Be more specific.
Right. Maybe there's a pattern. Can you analyze the reports and look at when the cars were stolen?
Where they were stolen.
What makes?
What years?
What colors?
What they were worth.
What about insurance?
What insurance companies?
How many dice?
What?
You know, fuzzy dice in the rearview mirror.
George, when you get specific, you get specific. I'll get to work on it. William. Uh-huh. I'll tell him. That was Bill Dietrich. He wants to talk to you.
We just saw him.
He wants to see you again. Upstairs? Out front.
You wanted to see us, Bill?
Yes, George, Kate. How's the investigation going?
Debbie's crunching some numbers for us.
Tell her to add one.
Oh?
My car has just been stolen.
The story you are about to see is a fib, but it's short. The names are made up, but the problems are real.
It was Monday, 11:43 a.m., and the unseasonably warm weather made things so hot, the Los Angeles Kings had to open the hockey season in a giant swimming pool. They lost in overtime. I was working the day watch out of Mathnet. The boss is Thad Green. My partner is George Frankly. My name is Monday. I'm a mathematician. Sergeant Bill Dietrich had asked for our help on a new case, a case that involved an unusual number of stolen automobiles being taken from, in, and around the greater Los Angeles area. We decided to eyeball a couple of scenes from yesterday's show to refresh our memories. Going over the facts is important in problem solving, and we had a big one to solve. Why are you showing this to us, Bill?
This is a bar graph that indicates car thefts in the greater Los Angeles area for the past 5 years, month by month.
A second graph indicated that car thefts were up, way up.
Just look at this.
What a jump.
In those 2 months, thefts are 295% of what they were for the same period last year.
295%? That's nearly three times as many.
We asked Debbie Williams, head of our computer lab, to help.
Something funny is going on, Debbie. I think what we need is to look at the information. It's all stored in a computer in the database.
Database, good. I was hoping we'd be able to use a computer software program that allows us to store all kinds of information and organize and reorganize it so it can be retrieved selectively. Weren't you, Kate?
More than anything in the world. Be more specific.
Right. Maybe there's a pattern. Can you analyze the reports and look at when the cars were stolen?
Where they were stolen.
What makes?
What years?
We got Debbie started on the problem and were called to meet Bill outside the office.
You wanted to see us, Bill?
Yes, George, Kate. How's the investigation going?
Debbie's crunching some numbers for us.
Tell her to add one.
Oh?
My car has just been stolen.
Your car was stolen, Bill?
You don't see it, do you?
Maybe it wasn't purloined by criminals. You know, swiped.
You have a better explanation based on the facts, do you, George?
Maybe it was towed away by the police for being left in a no parking zone.
Okay, I paid the fine. Now I have to go get the car.
Sorry, Bill.
Oh, it's my own fault. No excuse for parking in a tollway zone. I was in a hurry and didn't realize that I had done it.
How much they soak you, Willie?
George.
Can you deduct the fine from your taxes?
George.
All right. Thanks for the ride. I'm going back to the office.
See you later, Sergeant Dietrich.
Oh, I'm sorry. Excuse me.
Okay, no problem.
Oh, excuse me. I'm just upset. It's my car.
You have a car? I mean, you're so young.
I'm 16 years old.
And you have a car?
I had a car. It was my mother's and now it's gone.
Your mother's car was stolen?
No, it was towed away. And wouldn't you know?
Uh-huh.
It was the first time I ever got to drive it alone.
And you just got your license?
Mm-hmm.
What's your name?
Lisa. My mom let me take her car to go shopping. When I came out of the store, it was being towed away by a police wrecker.
Seems to be a lot of that going around.
Sir?
Nothing. So did you pay the fine and get the car back?
That's just it. They can't find the car. They say they didn't take it.
Then they probably didn't.
But they did. I saw it being towed. I ran after the wrecker but couldn't catch it.
Lisa, I'm George Frankly. This is Kate Monday. We're with Mathnet. We'll see if we can help you get to the bottom of this. You say you saw your mother's car being towed away, Lisa?
Uh-huh, that's right. And I even wrote down the wrecker's number.
317. Well, this should help us.
I'll call the traffic division.
My mother is going to be mad, and I don't blame her. This is the first time I get to drive alone, and this has to happen.
I'm sure your mother will understand, Lisa.
Hi, Phil. It's Kate Monday. Fine, thanks. Phil, can you get a list of all the cars your wrecker number 317 towed away today? Sure, I'll hold. They're checking in it. Yes? Are you sure? Okay, thanks. Lisa, LAPD doesn't have a wrecker by that number.
But I saw it with my own eyes.
Sometimes the eyes can play tricks on us.
I was sure it was 317.
Lisa, I'll get one of our people to drive you home. And if we come up with anything on your car, we'll be in touch.
But I want to help. Do you have all the information you need?
We've got everything, Lisa.
Don't you need my driver's license?
It's on file, Lisa.
But you want the registration number.
It's in our database, Lisa.
What about the pink slip?
It ain't necessary, Lisa.
Good luck, Lisa. We'll be in touch.
Poor kid. Remember the first time I got to drive alone? Backed the car right out of the garage without opening the door. What a funny sound.
I've got some info for you, Mathnetters.
Terrific, Teddy. Anything unusual?
I've checked car thefts in all precincts, and they show the same pattern.
What does that mean?
We have a problem that is citywide.
What else?
Here's a graph comparing some car makes. The blue bars represent average car thefts between January and June.
And the pink?
Average car thefts for July and August. The letters represent different makes of cars. A is Ferrari. Not much difference, right?
Uh-uh. Go on.
B is Porsche. Again, not much difference.
I rode in a Porsche once. It went fast.
C is for BMW. Again, no significant difference.
Martha's sister has a Beamer. Well, I've never ridden in it.
We do find a big difference in two makes. Cadillacs and Lincolns. The rest seem to be relative.
Cadillacs and Lincolns. Expensive cars.
Yes, but so are those high-performance sports cars.
Right. So maybe price isn't a factor. I even checked the colors of cars stolen.
Find anything?
No. The colors don't tell us anything. They just show an overall increase in theft. But no one color is being ripped off out of proportion to any other color. Look at this. Theft by model.
Four-door cars are up.
And station wagon thefts.
And RVs and truck thefts. There might be something there. Here's some raw figures. Last year, about 56,000 cars were stolen in our area.
Wow.
If we divide that figure by 12, we get a monthly average.
About 4,700 each month, on average.
But if we divide that by 4, we get about 1,200 cars per week. And if we divide that by 7, we get 170 cars per day. And if we divide that by 24, we get 7 cars per hour. And if we divide that by 60, well, a lot of cars are being swiped, average-wise.
There are a few more cars stolen in the summer, probably because they're more accessible.
Right. People go to the beach, outdoor concerts, ball games.
Right. And remember this. Here are the figures for the past 2 months of this year. About 13,000 cars were stolen in each of the last 2 months, July and August.
That's amazing.
Anything else unusual, Debbie?
I think so. If you were going to steal a car, when would you do it?
I guess I would wait till it got dark.
Uh-huh. Me too. Why?
Look. No significant increase between midnight and 8 a.m. or from 4 p.m. till midnight. but look at 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. A huge increase during the day, Monday through Friday. They don't seem to work weekends.
What do you make of that?
You got me.
8 to 4, Monday through Friday. Maybe all the car thieves formed a union and won't work overtime. Sorry.
Here's something else, Mathnetters. Usually LAPD recovers about 8 out of 10. Of the automobiles which were stolen.
That's pretty good.
But in the past 2 months, our recovery rate has dropped to about 3 out of 10, 30%.
That's interesting. But...
But what?
But what does it mean?
It means that almost 20,000 cars have disappeared from the streets of Los Angeles in the past 2 months.
Right off the face of the earth.
To see is a fib, but it's short. The names are made up, but the problems are real.
It was Tuesday, 9:43 a.m., and the traffic on the Santa Ana Freeway was so heavy people in Orange County couldn't get their cars out of their garages. I was working the day watch out of Mathnet. The boss is Thad Green. Head of our computer division is Debbie Williams. My partner is George Frankly. His dance instructor from an earlier episode still has sore feet. My name is Monday. I'm a mathematician. An incredible number of automobiles were being stolen in Los Angeles, and we couldn't find them. We decided to look at a couple of scenes from yesterday's program to establish what we knew for sure.
Last year, about 56,000 cars were stolen in our area.
Wow.
If we divide that figure by 12, we get a monthly average.
About 4,700 each month, on average.
In the midst of our investigation, we were temporarily sidetracked by a young girl who thought her mother's car had been towed away by an LAPD wrecker. We found that not to be the case.
My mother is going to be mad, and I don't blame her. This is the first time I get to drive alone, and this has to happen.
Debbie came up with some more interesting facts.
Here's something else, Mathnetters. Usually LAPD recovers about 8 out of 10. 80% of the automobiles which were stolen.
That's pretty good.
But in the past 2 months, our recovery rate has dropped to about 3 out of 10. 30%.
That's interesting. But
what?
But what does it mean?
It means that almost 20,000 cars have disappeared from the streets of Los Angeles in the past 2 months.
Right off the face of the earth.
Just warning your dance step, Kate. I don't think I'm ever gonna get it.
Yes, you will. Monday. Yes, Steve. Oh? Please send her in. Lisa is here, George.
The young lady with missing car?
Hello, Miss Monday, Mr. Frankly. Sorry to bother you, but I had a thought.
It's no bother, Lisa. What is it?
I was thinking, yesterday when my mom's car was stolen, it was awfully sunny and bright.
Uh-huh.
Maybe the wrecker pulling my mom's car wasn't 317.
We know it wasn't 317, Liso. LAPD doesn't have one by that number.
Right. Maybe it was 817. Maybe I only saw half the 8 because of glare or something, and it just looked like a 3.
I guess that's possible.
I'll check. Hi, Phil, it's Kate. Sorry to bother you again, but do you guys have a record with the number 817? Sure. Uh-huh. You do. Could you tell me what area it was working yesterday? Was it anywhere near?
Wilshire and Vermont.
Wilshire and Vermont? Oh, you sure? Thanks again, Phil.
Was it?
No. Number 817 has been in the shop for repairs for the past 3 days. Sorry, Liso.
It was a good thought, Liso. You keep thinking about the problem.
Yes, sir.
Huh? And we will, too.
Kate, if people in L.A. are losing their cars at the rate of about 10,000 a month, they must be replacing them. I mean, nobody in L.A. walks.
What do you mean?
I mean, car sales would figure to be up.
You're right, George. New and used car sales. Maybe these cars are being sold to used car dealers. We should ask an expert.
And who is the biggest used car dealer in the whole great big world?
According to his television commercials, it's...
Art Fraud. Art Fraud Motors.
Everything okay in here?
Sure, Deb. What do you got?
I don't know, but I was just looking over some more facts.
Uh-huh.
Look at this chart. Most of the cars, about 80% that were stolen in the past 2 months, were models built before 1975 or after 1984. Think that means anything?
I don't know. Let's ask a man who sells them.
That's right, folks. You heard Art Fraud more correctly than ever. Only 29 cents down for any of these beauties. That's right. 29 cents down and 29 cents a month for 29 months. Now, tell me, can you beat that? Of course, there is a substantial penalty for those of you that don't pay the $15,000 fine of balloon payment at the end of the 29th month. But hey, folks, there's no way you can go wrong with a fraud. Just check out these tires. One for every wheel.
I forgot he did his TV commercials live.
Plus, a round steering wheel to help the car go wherever you want it to. And this 1966 beauty comes equipped with a 1966 mirror, 1966 radio, and a lot of other 1966 extras. You buy this car and you'll say, no fooling, it's a dandy. All right, let's get back to used car theater and our wonderful film, Don't Touch That, My Nose is on Fire.
Mr. Fraud.
No, I'm still on camera.
Sorry, no touches.
Leo, we off yet? We off?
All clear.
You're luckier, my wife's cousin. Hi, friends. Art Fraud Motors.
Mr. Fraud, I'm Kate Monday. This is my partner, George.
Frankly, Mathnet.
Nice to know you. You two interested in buying a used car?
We're interested in 20,000 cars, Mr. Fraud.
Call me Art. It's much better for business. 20,000 cars, huh? Of course. Any particular color?
We're investigating car thefts, Mr. Fraud.
Oh, I know all about them.
You do?
What I mean is a lot of people have been coming in here and buying used cars because theirs have been stolen. It's been a madhouse, I'm telling you.
I'll bet it has.
But don't get me wrong. I mean, business has been fantastic. It's just that, a couple more months, I'll be out of cars.
Don't you have to buy an awful lot of cars to fill that need?
We buy good cars when they're offered, but so far that hasn't increased.
Not at all?
Nope. That supply has been the same for weeks. The only thing that's changed is the demand.
So as far as you know, the cars that have been stolen off the streets aren't showing up in used car lots?
Not at all. I've been talking to a lot of other used car dealers, and they're in the same predicament. More buyers than sellers, more demand than supply.
Any idea where these stolen cars might be going, Art?
Not really. The chop shops are out of business, so that's out. I guess they might be being shipped out of the country to Point South and sold down there, but I don't know anything about it.
We can check that. Well, thank you for your time, Mr. Art.
Anytime, okay?
Oh, one thing. Any idea what cars built before 1975 and after 1984 might have in common?
75 and 84. Let me see. Not much. Prices change. Styles change. Before 75, the cars were heavier. As a matter of fact, after 84, they got heavier again.
Hey!
What? Oh, excuse me. I'm on TV again. I love showbiz. Show them all my true light, Bill. Huh? Get the camera up. Come on. Get out. Get out.
11 out of 12.
Hi, folks. Art Fraud once again. When used car prices have you awed, that's the time to call Art Fraud.
11 out of 12. Come in.
You gotta give Art credit.
And Art will give anybody credit. Monday.
Mathnet, 3 more complaints about LAPD towaway.
What are the complaints?
Nobody can find the cars.
The story you're about to see is a fib, but it's short. The names are made up, but the problems are real.
It was Wednesday, 9:43 a.m., and the new rock group Hamlet's gang had sold so many tickets that traffic was backed up from the Greek Theater to Man's Chinese. I was working the day watch out of Mathnet. The boss is Thad Green. My partner is George Frankly. My name is Monday. I'm a mathematician. Cars, thousands of cars, were being stolen in the greater Los Angeles area. It was a problem of great magnitude. Our job? Solve it. In order to do so, we needed facts. Plenty of facts. We decided to look at a few scenes from yesterday's show to check things out.
Kate, if people in L.A. are losing their cars at the rate of about 10,000 a month, they must be replacing them. I mean, nobody in L.A. walks.
What do you mean?
I mean, car sales would figure to be up.
We needed an expert, and we decided to talk with L.A.'s leading car dealer, the flamboyant Art Fraud. He told us his sales were up. Way up.
Any idea where these stolen cars might be going, Art?
Not really. The chop shops are out of business, so that's out. I guess they might be being shipped out of the country to Point South and sold down there, but I don't know anything about it.
After leaving Art Fraud Motors, we got an unusual bit of information.
Monday.
Mathnet, 3 more complaints about LAPD towaway.
What are the complaints?
Nobody can find the cars.
After our visit with Art Fraud, we thought that the cars might have been shipped out of the country by sea and decided to investigate our theory at Long Beach Harbor.
So, you're in charge here, sir?
Yep, I'm Chief Warfinger.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Warfinger.
My name isn't Warfinger. I am a Warfinger.
A Warfinger is a man who controls a wharf, George.
Martha once thought she spotted a double-breasted Warfinger in our backyard.
George.
It was near our tree. What can I do for you landlubbers? I love it when they talk nautical.
Chief, we're investigating the disappearance of hundreds and hundreds of cars from the greater Los Angeles area. Is it possible that 20,000 cars could have been shipped out of this harbor?
I'll blister my barnacles if it doesn't happen all the time.
Boatloads of cars?
Swab my cargo net if it don't. You know, a ship can carry up to 6,000 cars over the bound in Maine.
So to move 20,000 cars...
You'd need, let's see, 6,000 goes into 20,000, 3 times with 2,000 left over, so you'd need 3 1/3 ships. Well, 4 ships to be safe.
Gussie up my gunnels if you wouldn't.
So it would be possible.
Yep, but not without my knowing it.
You know everything that comes through this harbor?
A pilot on a peg leg couldn't get in or out of these docks without this old sea dog's ears pricking up.
You're on top of everything?
In the crow's nest.
So the missing cars couldn't have been shipped out of here in the past 2 months?
Absolutely not. If you think those cars were shipped out of here, you're sliding down the wrong bowsprit.
What about a super tanker? How much weight can they carry?
A big oil tanker can carry 300,000 tons.
The cars average about 3,000 pounds.
3,000 times 20,000 is 60 million. There are 2,000 pounds in a ton. The cars would weigh 30,000 tons.
But super tankers carry liquid. Cars are solid. Those ships are not outfitted to carry solid cargo. And like I said, I know everything that comes in and out. And nothing like that happened. Blast my ballast if it did.
Thank you, Chief.
We'll let you get back to your hobby. How long you been at it?
Over 50 years, man and boy.
Wow. How many ships have you built in bottles in all that time?
I don't build them.
Oh?
People bring me bottles that some swab jockey put a boat in, and I take it out.
I see.
Yeah, in my lifetime, I probably salvaged 1,500 bottles.
Uh-huh.
You know, a bottle ain't good for much with a boat on the inside of it.
I guess not. Thanks for your help, Chief.
We were certain that the cars hadn't been shipped out of the country, but to make sure, George checked the airports.
Good. Thank you. No, they weren't flown out, Kate. The largest cargo plane available could carry 40 cars. That means to carry 20,000 cars, you'd need 500 flights. Air traffic control would have picked that up, and they didn't.
Monday. Send her in, Steve. Hopefully so.
Any news, Miss Monday?
Not yet, Lisa.
Hi. I've done some checking on the official wreckers reports.
Looks like more people have seen cars being towed away and not turning up at an impound area.
Just like my mom's car?
Mm-hmm.
Kate? Debbie? I hate to say it, but maybe we've got a rogue cop on our hands. Someone who is using his position as a trusted wrecker driver to steal these cars.
That's possible.
I thought of the same thing, and I checked on these people.
And?
There are about 150 wreckers. All of their drivers have been on the job for at least 3 years, and they have excellent records. They're above reproach.
What if it's not one of them?
We're pretty sure it wasn't, Lisa.
Wait, you mean...
What if someone else has a wrecker? Yes. And they painted it to look like an official wrecker.
It would take quite a while for one wrecker to steal 20,000 cars.
Maybe it's a fleet of wreckers. I've got an idea.
I had to talk to the chief and lay out my complicated plan. The chief sent out an order for all official wreckers to be taken off the streets for the rest of today and tomorrow, too.
The chief has pulled our wreckers off the streets, and all LAPD cruisers have been told to watch for any towing activity.
So if we see any, we'll know it's some phony wrecker.
Now, let's play What Do We Know?
What do we know?
It's a way of looking at facts. We know 20,000 cars have been stolen in Los Angeles and not recovered.
And we know from all our wreckers that they haven't left the area by sea or air.
And highway patrol records don't show any unusual traffic on the roads.
And we know that some of the cars are new, and some are pretty old.
And you think you know how they're being stolen?
Yes, Lisa, but not for sure. George, remember what Art Fraud said in Wednesday's episode?
Sure. He said for 29 cents down and 29 cents a month.
I mean about the stolen cars, what the old and the new had in common.
Oh, right. He said they were all heavy cars.
A lot of cars used to be heavier before the gasoline crisis of 1973, and they got heavier after gasoline got cheaper again.
Remember the charts on models and makes stolen? Heavy cars and trucks? Between 1973 and 1984, auto manufacturers made lighter cars so they would get better gas mileage and be cheaper to operate. What are you getting at, Kate?
It's just a hypothesis, but there are 20,000 heavy cars that someone has stolen. There's not a place to put that many cars without somebody noticing them. So what if the cars aren't being sold as cars?
What else would they be sold as? Planters?
Junk. Right. What if they are being sold as scrap metal?
Sure. Lots of times when you trade in an old car, the dealer just sells it to somebody, and that somebody recycles the metal.
Let me make a couple of phone calls to scrap metal dealers. Good idea, Debbie. In the meantime, George, let's hit the streets and see if we can catch any of those phony wreckers.
Can I help?
You have helped, Lisa.
Come on. We'll give you a ride home.
But the problems are real.
The low clouds met the high winds over the deep Pacific near the shallow coast and made it one of those days everyone cherishes about Southern California. It was Wednesday, 3:43 p.m. I was working the day watch out of Mathnet. The boss is Thad Green. Head of our computer division is Debbie Williams. My partner is George Frankly. My name is Monday. I'm a mathematician. We've been working very hard trying to solve a problem that involved the disappearance of nearly 20,000 automobiles from the greater and near greater Los Angeles area over the past 2 months. We decided to look at a couple of earlier scenes to refresh our gray matter, our brains.
Hi, I've done some checking on the official records reports. Looks like more people have seen cars being towed away and not turning up in an impound area.
Just like my mom's car?
Mm-hmm.
Kate? Debbie? I hate to say it, but maybe we've got a rogue cop on our hands. Someone who is using his position as a trusted wrecker driver to steal these cars.
I had an idea. I talked with the chief, and he agreed to take all official wreckers off the streets for 2 days.
So if we see any, we'll know it's some phony wrecker.
George and I were driving our friend, Lee So, home when we saw a phony wrecker with a car in tow. At last. Our luck had changed.
Hit it, George.
Unfortunately, our luck had changed from bad to worse.
Sorry, Kate, I lost him in traffic.
That's okay, Pard.
We'll get another chance. Several of the stolen cars were limousines, big, heavy cars which had been stolen from the Los Angeles airport. We decided to check it out.
Got an explanation for that, sir?
Well, these drivers usually have someone important to pick up, so they park here in these no-parking zones while they go inside to meet their passenger.
How long are they inside?
I don't know exactly. Varies from 10 to 45 minutes, I guess. Depends on whether the flight's on time or not. Most of them aren't.
Did you notice if any were towed away yesterday?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, Quite a number of them. I'd say at least six.
And the official records were out of service then.
Ma'am?
Come on, George.
The white zone is for immediate loading and unloading of passengers only. No parking. La zona blanca es únicamente para el inmediato abordaje y desembarque de pasajeros, no para estacionar.
We decided to lay a trap. We rented a car from a car service, and George hid in the back seat. Steve and Sam staked out the car. If it was towed away, they would follow it, and we'd have our thief. As a safety backup, George was equipped with an electronic homing device.
We'll have your mother's car back real soon, Lisa.
Hi, you two. Where's George?
Debbie, right this very minute, he's being baited in a math trap.
He may really have discovered the answer to this mystery. I've checked the scrap metal business.
What'd you find?
Scrap metal sells for about $15 per ton. A car weighs, on average,
about 1.5 tons. But they were stealing the heavy cars, and they weigh, on the average, 4,000 pounds. 2 tons.
Right. So if each car were sold as junk, it would bring about $30.
$30 isn't very much money.
It is when you figure there are about 20,000 of them.
Yes, that's about, $600,000.
That's right, Lisa.
And they don't have to worry about getting caught selling stolen cars on the street.
Never thought of that.
What's that?
Sam or Steve. We set up special communication. Monday.
Hi, Kay, it's Steve. Nothing suspicious so far. We just wanted to check in.
Thanks, Steve. Keep me posted.
I probably learned more than I ever want to know about scrap metal processing, Kay.
That's so? Like what?
Do you know how they deal with junk cars?
No, I guess I don't.
Normally, a car is taken to an auto dismantler.
What does he do, Miss Williams?
He dismantles it. Takes everything of value off the car, like the motor, the transmission, things like that. Then it goes to a processor.
What do they do?
They use a gigantic hydraulic compressor, which squishes the car into a waffle.
That must take a lot of pressure.
Mm-hmm. And they can compact the car very quickly, less than a minute.
And a car that's only about that thick would be a lot easier to store.
And get this, Kate. Scrap metal sales in the past 2 months have nearly doubled. It's a big business.
That must be what they're doing.
You mean they're going to make my mom's car into a little pancake?
It's Steve and Sam. Monday. Got something, Steve?
Yes, Kate, a phony wrecker just hooked onto the nose of George's car.
It's being towed away.
Stay with him, Steve.
Will do, 10-4.
Hey, buddy, move the car.
Steve, what's going on over there?
George is being towed away. We're blocked in by a van.
Tell him to move.
I did. His motor's stalled.
George's car is being towed out of sight. You've got to tail him, Kate. License number is 313-313.
Come on. George has a homing device. Maybe we can follow him.
I hope so. If that compactor gets a hold of him.
Don't say it, Debbie.
We knew what we knew and what we didn't know. George was in a car that was marked for compacting. We knew that. Where the compactor was located, we didn't know. We had to drive hard.
Have you got George's homing signal, Kate?
I'm looking. His device is set on frequency 84.56. That's George. 84.56. The closer we get, the louder the signal will get. Steve, where are you?
We finally got loose, and we're proceeding east on Century Boulevard, following the sound. Where are you, Kate? Over.
We're on the beam, Steve. At Firehouse and Compton. We're not that far apart.
Roger, stay in touch. Our signal's getting stronger.
Right. We're gonna make it. Don't worry. LA traffic was heavy, and I was having trouble staying with the signal.
Kate, we're losing the signal. Do you have it?
It's fading in and out, Steve. Keep on the beam.
We're trying, Kate. Good luck.
Debbie, it's faded. George's batteries are dead.
It's Mondays. Look, there's ghosts.
Locked electronically.
Let's go around.
Thank you.
Don't try anything or I'll splatter you all over this place. Take them away, boys.
George, you're all right?
Never felt better, Kate. Sure I am.
George, we were worried. We thought you might have been in the car.
In the car? Are you kidding? I could have been all messed up. No. I rolled out of the car as soon as I figured out what they were going to do.
Take him in, Sam. Nice work, Steve.
I thought we'd lost you that time, George.
No way, Steve.
Glad you're okay, George. Remember, you owe me $10.
You'll get it.
Look.
What?
It's my mom's car!
You okay, George?
Uh-huh. Except for one thing.
What's that?
It's only 3 hours before I have to go to the dance with Martha. Still don't know how to...
Theft ring, Henry Edsel III, was tried and convicted of 20,000 counts of 487.3 PC car theft gross. He was sentenced to an appropriate number of years away from society and the automobile aftermarket.